So, it's been a bit over a year since AMD's new Ryzen CPUs burst onto the scene and really gave us some fantastic bang for the buck multi-threaded performance. While a bit behind in gaming compared to Intel's current offerings, Ryzen was made a compelling choice due to its strength and productivity given its mainstream price. I switched to Ryzen around August of last year, and I have to say I've quite enjoyed it. But what if I were to tell you that there's a Ryzen killer lurking out there? And no, I'm not talking about Intel's Coffee Lake CPUs. The CPUs that I'm referring to are Westmere Xeons. Today I'll be taking a look at three of these Xeons, one 6-core 12-thread, one 4-core 8-thread, and one 4-core 4-thread, each clocked to 4.2 GHz and paired with 16 GB of 1600 MHz DDR3 RAM and my RX Vega 64 graphics card. The competition from the red corner will be a Ryzen 3 1200, Ryzen 5 1400, and Ryzen 5 1600, each overclocked to 3.85 GHz with 16 GB of 3200 MHz DDR4, and once again, my RX Vega 64. I know Ryzen has the higher clocked RAM here, by far, but please don't crucify me just yet. These results may actually surprise you. So let's see how these cheapest chips Xeons hold up against AMD's current lineup of Ryzen CPUs. Well, I suppose it might be more accurate to call these CPUs Ryzen competitors rather than Ryzen killers, at least in terms of raw performance. They managed to get fairly close in synthetics, but Ryzen still had a clear advantage. In gaming, however, they're just barely trailing behind. Now, after all of that said and done, let's take a look at these CPUs in terms of cost. You can snag the 6-core Xeon X5650 for around $35 on eBay, while the other two can be had for under $10 each. A motherboard will set you back at least $100, and maybe about $150 if you want one of the higher-end boards, and around $80 for 16GB of DDR3 memory on the used market, and $20 for a decent cooler. Compare that with a Ryzen 5 1600, which can be had for as low as $149 at the moment, B350 boards for around $60-ish, and 16GB of DDR4 for about $149. Assuming that you just use the stock Wraith cooler, the Ryzen build will still set you back way more than these Xeons. However, going for the Xeon will leave you trapped on the X58 platform with no possible upgrade path. So before you jump on these, be sure to consider that. Are you fine with near Ryzen performance for far cheaper but with no upgrade path whatsoever, or do you want to jump onto a platform that's going to be supported until 2020? Choose carefully, buy wisely. Anyway, that's it for this one, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.